The birds were all over the place after the rain. Today is Tuesday, and nobody is working. Probably because of water. Do they hope it's gonna dry out? The only true freedom you can find is inside your mind. And even for that, you need to work a lot to remove all the layers. No, maybe not all, but many layers of your upbringing, of unwanted influences. This tranquility after destruction is simply fascinating. Tons of life is constantly destroyed, and life goes on regardless who's gone, what we've lost. Many vegans on the internet, they use word mother nature a lot, or natural, or you know, nature would take care of everything. I let nature to care about me, my hygiene, my well-being, everything. Nature could care less about you. You, it's not a being, it's not even an organism, it's an obstruction we have in our mind. And you have nothing to do with it. You're just a part of it, and you have no special relationship. The same goes for your species, for humans, for example. It doesn't matter to what we call species, how you behave, what you do, how do you feel. You're not supposed even to be happy all the time. You're supposed to be happy as a difference from being unhappy, to motivate your actions in specific direction, to survive and to procreate. We're just experiments, we individual beings, just to see how good of a individual from this particular species we are. Should we go on? Should we let our genes survive? Many people can derive satisfaction by following the call of nature to do what it intended you to do. Not intended, but if you act in favor of your species survival, survival of your species, of your kin, of your blood.
Morning.
Ideas, beauty, and discoveries, those have chance to survive after you and maybe create more significant impact than a child. I'm not quite sure of that. But for some of us, it is definitely the case. My favorite age in kids is teenage. Teenagers, they're so interesting. These guys are friendly. Almost everyone here is friendly. So teenagers, they remind me about a very important period in my life. I like them, even if they're still dummies. kept something in my routine from the Grand Mat Bar. Dancing exercise, ballet actually, the classical one. We had that training. So you keep your leg up there and go down. Or you keep your leg straight and sit down with your other leg. Yeah, like that. I love this. It's a stretch and exercise in the same time. And of course you do it for another leg afterwards, and then you switch. And then you put your leg like that there, and then you turn, still standing on this one, and pushing the other foot towards your head, doing the same stuff. Let me show you what I do with my leg. I kind of push it with my hand, and then up, and then I go down. I used to have this stuff in my apartment in Europe, which I had. I still have it. Yeah, stuff like this. It's normally thinner, narrower, more like this. Oh, it's so good. I miss it so much. But now I rent. You still can buy those for at least, it goes up to from $100. And you don't need to attach them to the wall or to the floor. They take quite a bit of space though. So now after this I am so refreshed, I'm gonna run again. Now I'm walking on the outside of my feet and now on the inside sort of a corner or surface. And outside and inside. This is a dance position in which I stretch too. So I just go back with my all my upper body. I do the same this way, and I can show you, I guess, on my shadow. Not much, I just go back. Another problem I see with the young YouTubers, like in their 20s maybe, that many of them don't know what they don't know. I don't know why, but they think they know a lot or everything in the specific area. They don't try to educate themselves that much. At least this is my general impression. It's tricky to film it. With normally I hold this thing and do grand mama, but now it's funny, but I'm gonna continue. Your leg should be straight but relaxed, and the other leg should stay straight. Then you turn towards this thing and push your leg towards this side. This is how far I go now, but it was much further before. I was in over negative split easily at my dancing times, actually at all times from my, I think from the time I really wanted to go to a ballet school, I was like what, 6 or 7. My mom was a ballet dancer in her youth, but she didn't continue with the career. She went to finance and built her a very successful career there. But at our home we still had, you know, books about ballet and pictures and watching the concerts, not the concerts, the theater. And of course I was influenced. My favorite ballet dancer, Maya Plisetska, died recently. That was sad. I like also modern dance a lot. Well, of course I was dancing it. I think it's like liking a piano, most of other instruments in symphony and orchestras and concerts, just because you played it and you can feel how you would play the same piece. It adds a lot to the satisfaction from the music. So, and with the modern dance, oh, the other day I found a new video by Mylène Farmer. It's a French popular singer, and she had a couple dancing a love relationship. Oh my gosh, that was impressive. I'm definitely not a natural runner. I always have some sort of aches if I do too much. Right now I feel a little bit of ache for here. Soon I will have probably nothing else to show you, and I won't film on my runs. I used to have a sports bag in my car, just in case if I happen to be in an interesting location, right after I finish my project, filming or lesson, that I can take an advantage and run before I drive home. But then I took it back. Today I have a little bit more time, so I intend to show you that lake. This is a creek split here, and there is a lake. I wonder whether you can see it in the shadow. Wow, can you see the bird? Freaking awesome. Should I wait? It's gonna fly away now. So this is the lake. There are two lakes here. Another one I've already shown you. It is closer to the ocean. This lake is much smaller. When I studied filmmaking, some of my fellow students had no good equipment. And I was thinking, oh my gosh, how do they manage with such bad cameras, like bad lens? And now, here I am, trying to film something with my phone. My gosh, I miss my lens, I miss my camera so much, the filters. But I do believe it's unrealistic to make vlogs with the full equipment. It would take me many hours a day. Like Casey Neistat, 16 hours per day. Well, he employed much more equipment, but still, I can't do that. What I realized recently is that YouTube and other sites, they're making content creators to beggars. People back, please subscribe, please follow, please. Oh my gosh. I need to go away. Please. Like. Oh gosh. And then explain how much they need money and explain how much work is goes into it. And people don't understand. It looks easy. And of course I know how much work it is. But it is paid so little, so little, especially if you don't have a lucky situation of viral spreading of one of your videos. When I studied economics, for a while I was going to specialize in marketing. I'm glad I didn't, but I still have that interest, so I follow some sites and read some articles. So the new thing nowadays is community building. You create a community of loyal followers around you, and you build human relationships with your viewers. And of course the YouTuber is doing that, so you can often hear that I love you guys, I love each and every one of you, I miss you. Well, obviously they don't love anybody specifically, they love just the idea of an attention, of some attention from many people at once. It brings them money and it's very flattering. Well, trying to sell a product is bad enough. And then now with the video productions, you give the results for free and then you beg that people pay you anyway. Well, you know, don't beg, you ask. But with some individuals online, it just almost, oh, it's painful to watch, seriously. I think relying on mass behavior, like in viewership, is very risky. It's riskier than providing some sort of product for specific price, because you know, the steadiness of demand somehow. You some sort of, you invest in advertisement and you have a number of clients each month, you can predict something. With popularity you can do probably the same, but it seems like there are many people who go up and then down, and in the good times they used to rely on this income. Personal marketing is a big part of the marketing. It has its own principles, but I think in general it's more risky because large groups of people may stop liking you at once because of something you said, you did, and then your position is shaken. And the investment is huge, as with most channels. It takes time. If you even make videos where when you just talk to the camera, you still need some editing. You need to render the video, you need to upload it, you need to name it and tag it and post it and share it. Even the primitive videos as mine require a couple of hours a day for each video. I think it's a minimum, I think it's more. If you compare that, those pennies that you receive per video to the minimal wages in California, for example, it's, I think it's around $11 now. You can see how little your work actually values. I'm going to switch off the disturbing advertisement on all of my videos. Because the advice people gave me, or I read or listened, it was, I think it was a privileged vegan who said her subscriptions and her views dramatically went down when she removed advertisement. So she put all the advertisement back on. So I tried to do that just to promote a little bit my videos, and nothing changed. it's nothing. Maybe her channel is much bigger and it acts differently. I did notice that if I watch several videos from a smaller channel, their videos are not recommended to me that much. Maybe sometimes, really seldom. But if I watch or clicked by mistake on a video of a bigger channel, oh my gosh, I'm like spammed by YouTube with a promotion. They appear on the side of the videos. Other videos I watch, completely irrelevant topics, and on my recommended page. It's just awful. YouTube started as a YouTube, you know, you to give people to express their opinions, to share their lives. Now it's far from that. No one cares about new video makers or speakers. It became an outlet for professional media teams who can make money, probably. And with the big social media companies like YouTube or Facebook, you don't know the rules. They're always changing someone else's decision based on profits. You have nothing to do with that. Wish you a great day.